Greetings, all you gallant gamers. Welcome back to another video. My name is Mango Crumble, and we are going to be reacting to the official trailer for the Cowboy Bebop Netflix show that is coming out. I have reacted to the intro. I might actually put like a link somewhere on the screen, you can react to that first. And I also have reacted to the lost session thing, but I haven't recorded that. But that was something I did off screen. So the original intro, I thought it was kind of all right. I didn't really know how I'd feel about it, how I felt about it. But, like, it was kind of, you know, there was something I liked, some things I didn't like. With the lost session one, I kind of felt more towards the negative side on that, because I just didn't like what they were doing, and there were just some things which kind of... I mean, there were some good parts to it. Like, I guess the editing was quite good, but... there were just some parts which just stuck out to me, and this part that stuck out to me weren't good. But this is the official trailer, so hopefully we get more stuff on the story, and just the overall plot, and just more stuff on, like, Spike and his sort of story, which is probably what the most not important part, but the thing I'm most excited to see, and I think the one thing that I still sort of had faith in this adaptation is Spike's story, I guess, and Spike, but with a few exceptions. But yeah, let's jump into it. I won't do that much talking over it with the trailer. I will do a little bit of talking, but I'll try to keep it to a minimum-ish, but then I'll go back on it and kind of break it down and just kind of look through it and talk about my thoughts and everything. So yeah, it is 2 minutes 40 long, and yeah, we'll just jump into it.
So what brings you back from the dead?
A week ago, I did a job. A bounty. I had a partner, believe it or not.
He know what you used to be?
I think he's talking about Vicious. I like the music, actually. That's quite good.
Will I ever see you again?
They tried to kill me, Anna. If you need to find me. I go by Spike Spiegel these days.
I thought he always did. CGI is looking a lot better in this trailer.
There's no happy ending here.
Spoken like a man who's never been in love.
I was.
What happened?
I was dreaming.
What do you say, fellas? You want to team up?
I was thinking a 60-40 split.
Going my way, of course.
Do not shoot her.
Please?
No.
What the actual fuck?
We're a team. The three of us. Go grab some bounties.
Please, I just want to kill him a little bit.
God damn it, Spike. It's Jamie.
Happens.
Depends on who you ask.
And there we go. Okay, so compared to the last one I saw, this was a little bit better, to be honest with you. Some things I still feel kind of iffy about, some things I do like. I'm just going to pick apart some things which I didn't recognise from the actual anime itself. So, as we can see, there's a swordfish there, Spike just looking on to the city. I guess that's that must be like Tokyo or something, because they do go there in the anime. Do I recognise that? I'm not sure if I do. I think there's this part where he says, hang on, let's get
a bounty.
Also, I kind of recognise the music there. I'm not really sure what it's from, but I do like it quite a bit. Well, that's right next to Jupiter.
Partner, believe it or not.
He know what you used to be.
I think he's definitely talking about Vicious there, because he said he had a partner in the back when he was a when he was part of the Red Dragon Crime Syndicate.
Will I ever see you again?
They tried to kill me, Anna. If you need to find me.
Okay, so when he says that, actually, in the spoilers, by the way, for Cowboy Bebop, the actual anime itself, at the end, they do try to kill Spike. Red Dragon Crime Syndicate comes after him, but like earlier on, they don't think they really cared as much. Although maybe I'm misremembering it. I'm not sure. That could have changed that.
By Spike Spiegel these days.
Okay, so when he says that, like, I'm a little bit confused because, like, I mean, we didn't really see much of his past in the original anime. He's just talked about it, and there was like little flashbacks, but there wasn't actual like not that many actual scenes of him. But he says, I go by Spike Spiegel these days, but I thought, I mean, doesn't he always go by Spike Spiegel? Isn't that just his name? Although, actually, I don't remember, because there was a flashback scene with Julia in the anime, where Julia refers to him as Spike, but she's never says Spike Spiegel, so that Spike Spiegel could have changed. He could have changed his name to that, but I think he's always gone by Spike, so I'm not sure how I feel about that. Maybe he could not be talking literally. I don't know. Netflix series. That's a Bebop. That's Jet. Also, you do see that in the anime as well, because they're going through the ports, and they actually go do that so they can get to other planets faster, because it's like a hyperspeed thing. Also, this is actually quite cool. The way they're doing it with the Bebop ship landing in the water, that is actually something that does happen in the anime. I keep referring to the anime, but you know what I mean. But that is actually something that Bebop does, because it was originally a boat, I think. Or no, it was a sea sort of ship that was originally meant to be on the sea. So the fact that they're doing that, and although it does do that in the original, but the fact that they're showing that, and actually it doesn't look that bad, like, CGI wise. Like, when I saw the original intro thing, I thought the CGI looked a bit off there, but this actually looks quite realistic. Especially the waves coming in. Okay, so I recognize this guy. He is the the mate of Jet. And he is, I can't remember him, but yeah. So, also another thing, that's Jet's, I think it's called the Rhino, the Kappa Rhino. In the original, he has a... I've already mentioned this before, but he has a Walther P99. Also, that's Vicious. Still, I'm not really sure about Vicious. I think, to be honest, out of everything in this adaptation, Vicious is probably my least favourite part. I've heard him talk a little bit, but I just don't like the way he looks, really. That's kind of the main problem with me and what I think about Vicious.
Like a man who's never been in love.
I was.
What happened?
Actually, that bit there with the where he drops the rose, that was in the memory scene at the very start of the anime.
What happened?
I was dreaming.
Yeah, actually, so he said that is actually a thing that he does say, like his life's like a dream that he's never woken up from. But he's kind of saying it in a slightly different way. I mean, I do kind of I think it might be a good idea just to try and mix up a little bit in terms of like the dialogue, or not the dialogue, but the things, the way they refer to stuff from the anime, because if they just copy and paste it, it'll just feel like the same thing again. But if they kind of fit it in differently, then that's a better idea. A bit more of the fight scenes.
What do you say, fellas? You want to team up? I was thinking a 60-40 split.
Okay, so I think actually that's kind of interesting. I can't remember if I'm remembering this right. Yeah, so Faye in this was just, she was wearing a similar dress to this just after in Ballad of the Fallen Angels, I think. I can't remember that well, but I think she was wearing a similar dress to this in Ballad of the Fallen Angels, so that actually could mean that she could have teamed up with them by then. If that's how they're doing it.
You want to team up? I was thinking a 60-40 split.
Okay, so they're talking about, like, how they split the money. And they do sort of talk about that in the anime a little bit, like, how they split the money. But that was, Faye was introduced, like, very early on. Well, in the third episode, I believe. Yeah. So... Also, we have Ayn, Spike's, Jericho there. I mean, that does look like the correct... That is the correct gun that he has. Yeah.
Please, no.
Those people are... I recognise that. Let's get to, this part. I think these are the Crime Syndicate people. You see them a little bit in the anime, but they just come back after them. That is what has excited me the most. That is the machine that they have in the episode Brain Freeze, which is basically, it sends them to this kind of virtual reality world where they upload their consciousness into a... into this cloud, and it's definitely my favorite episode of the anime, but, well, not my favorite episode, but just one of my favorites. But yeah, that is quite exciting for me. But yeah, okay, so we get more shots of the Crime Syndicate. Although I can't remember them having an army. Is that supposed to be the Crime Syndicate? I'm not sure. That is Pret LeFou, I believe, the kind of nutter guy. I'm not really sure about how the way he looks. He didn't look, I mean, he looked a bit mental in the original, I mean, you have to admit, but he looked a little bit more kind of unhinged than kind of theatrical. I mean, he did look theatrical, but he looked more kind of slightly just like a really unhinged guy in this weird outfit. But this guy just looks like a weird theatrical person in an outfit, if you know what I mean. But yeah.
We what the actual fuck?
Okay, so that's Spike saying what the actual fuck. I can't remember Spike or any of them swearing that much. I think there was a bit of swearing. I mean, they did swear, but like they didn't really F-bomb that much. I mean, I'd have a problem with it, really. They're allowed to do what they want with it, and yeah, but it's a little... You don't really hear Spike or much of the crew. I mean, they do swear, but they just say, like, shit or other stuff, but they don't really swear with, like, really that harsh swear words that often.
Oh, fuck.
Then we get Spike on what I believe is the kind of... I forgot what they're called. They're like a kung fu, like, training board thing. I actually kind of like that I think he does might have one in the anime, but I can't remember, but that's him just practicing his kung fu on it, and just martial arts.
We're a team. The three of us.
Okay, so this is a bit of Faye just going at him with a little punch knife there. To be honest, I'm not really that big a fan of that. Faye generally wasn't that much of a kind of melee fighter. Although she did, like, punch people, quite a bit. Generally, she just kind of... She does use a gun a bit, but generally she just did a lot of shooting and punching. But she never really used knives. And, yeah, it's a bit weird to see her kind of go all ninja, which is... Not exactly what Faye does, really. So I'm not... To be honest, I'm not a big fan of that. Yeah.
The three of us. Go grab some bounties.
Please, I just want to kill you a little bit.
God damn it, Spike. It's
Also, this part where it says, whatever happens, happens, that is, a quote that they have at the end of every episode. So they have a little black, screen, and they have, like a little, thing at the bottom. You'll recognize it from my intro thing, but yeah. He says that when he's, like, about to die at this point. Spike says it. Whatever happens, happens. Okay, so Spike's not holding his Jericho. He's holding a... I think that's a P... that's a PT-26, I think. And he's... This is the Ballad of the Fallen Angels scene that I was talking about. That does look quite cool, although I'm not a big fan of Vicious, but... I mean, I'm glad that... That is the exact same pose that they have from the anime. Okay, so we had this guy reloading. Kind of in a bit of a fight there. Jetson is kind of noir get up there. Although, actually, that could be a flashback scene. Because you do see Jet in, I forgot the episode. There's episode which is basically about Jet's past. And he does kind of wear this sort of old school, like, fedora and trench coat. Look in when he was younger, when he was actually a policeman. But yeah, those are I forgot what they're called, but they're the people who like turn people to monkeys or something. Going through some kind of little countryside bit there. She is the head of the what do they call themselves? The I don't know, I can't remember, but she's basically in charge of, hang on, let's get to the part. No, oh, I can't find it. Where is it? Come on. Never mind. Okay, so basically, when you saw the people with the, like, the masks and stuff, she's basically the, so these people. So she's the head of these people, with the masks. And, yeah.
We're bad, guys.
Depends on who you ask.
That's the swordfish. Actually, the, CGI there actually didn't look that bad. Okay, so... that is the end of the trailer. After I did my little breakdown, so let me just talk about my thoughts a little bit more. I'm just kind of taking this in because I haven't really fully thought about it. There's some parts which I don't think I'm going to change my mind on, like Vicious and Faye. I mean, there was some slightly redeeming parts about Faye. I think just like, she does sort of have that slightly condescendingness about her, which is actually slightly accurate. But like, the whole thing with the knife, which was a bit annoying because that was just, it just didn't seem right. Also, I don't really have much problems with Spike or Jet, really. Also, that's kind of interesting, like how are they like spacing out the episodes, because I recognised there were some scenes which looked like, because the bit with saying where Faye, I'm joining up with you, but she's wearing the dress that's in Ballad of the Fallen Angels. So it seems like, because they're condensing it, they could be doing the same episode for where they meet Faye and there's that. So they're kind of trying to fit a lot into one episode. I'm not sure how that's going to turn out. So they're just trying to get everything out of the way. Also, I didn't see any Ed in it. If you don't know who Ed is, she's like the kind of, like the little kid that in the anime, who's just like a really good hacker and has a lot of personality. But yeah. I didn't see any Ed, which is slightly disappointing, because they said they're going to have Ed in it, but I've literally seen no Ed whatsoever, except there was, like, this little teaser thing. So I think Ed's probably just going to be an Easter egg, really, which is a shame, because Ed's, I think, deserves a lot more screen time, but I kind of get it, because they're having to do a really short amount of episodes. So, I'm feeling a bit better about it than I did with the original, the Lost Session one, which I wasn't a big fan of, but I'm kind of feeling equal to how I felt with the intro, so I'm feeling like there will be some redeeming qualities to it, but there's just going to be some stuff that annoys me, so I think it's going to be kind of a mixed bag from what I can see so far. But the positive side, that it will bring people to watch the anime more, so it'll actually make the anime a little bit more relevant, and, it'll just spark some talk about it, and once it would revive the franchise, because it's not really a franchise, but, it would kind of, it would bring in more fans to the anime, and that's a good thing. So I think it's doing a good thing in that sense. But yeah, we haven't seen it yet, so I can't really give a full judgment on it. But from this, we have a much better idea of it. And I'm kind of feeling a bit kind of 50-50 about it. But actually, just let me know in the comments how you feel about it. Do you feel, like, positive about it? Do you feel like it's going to be really good? Do you think it's going to be bad? Do you think it's going to be all right? Or do you think it's, is it a good thing that it's bringing in fans to the series? Or is it going to, like, what are your thoughts on how it's going to turn out? That's the end of that, really. If you like the video, you can like it. If you dislike the video, I guess you can dislike it, you just didn't like the video, and you can subscribe if you're enjoying my content, and yeah, I will see you in the next video. I will see you later.